sound system didn't get turned on, so sorry. How old was Mozart when he wrote his 25th symphony?
Four.
Not a bad guess. He was 17 years old. He wrote his 25th symphony, so that was just the first movement of it. This is the Bethany Lutheran College Chamber Orchestra. I'm Professor Ben Fogstead. So happy to see you all here this beautiful afternoon. We almost call it a winter concert, but you hardly can, right? So, our next selection, Palladio, was inspired by the 16th century Italian architect Andrea Palladio. The composer Carl Jenkins writes, "Two of Palladio's hallmarks are mathematical harmony and architectural elements borrowed from classical antiquity, a philosophy which I feel reflects my own approach to composition." Total length of Palladio is 16 minutes, but we'll just be performing the first of his three movements. Here's Palladio. We have a wonderful collaboration to highlight, courtesy of Professor Jasperson and his students. It's a unique artist collaboration combining sight and sound, thereby fusing our musical performance with artwork. Take something in music that is otherwise temporary in a way, create art, in a way throughout art makes it permanent. So that's this that you received here. All right, so you've got this staple. Hopefully you received that. So you're going to see artists featured here for a few of our selections, and the first one is coming up right now. Adagio for strings, and then Celtic Roots, and then if you open it like this, then there's three for our very last selection, Jupiter, as well as the artist's description. Just out of curiosity, are these artists present? Are any of them present? Would you put your hand up in the air if you are present? You are, right here. Oh, and this is yours, this very first one, so wonderful. Could you stand and be recognized, please? And also another, Nora, right? So, and Lydia, I'm sorry, you are hiding in the back. So Nora and Lydia, not related. They're, and then those are on that Jupiter page. So could you guys stand up too and wave and everyone can look at you? And, yeah. Samuel Barber composed Adagio for strings in 1936. In January 1938, Barber sent an orchestrated version of the Adagio for strings to Arturo Toscanini, famous conductor of the NBC Symphony Orchestra. The conductor returned the score without comment, which annoyed Barber. Toscanini eventually sent word that he was planning to perform the piece and had returned it simply because he had already memorized it. It was reported that Toscanini did not look at the music again until the day before the premiere, November 1938. Many compare Adagio for Strings' role in American music to that of Edward Elgar's Nimrod for the British. And here's yet another English comparison. Adagio was voted as one of the saddest classical works ever, just ahead of Henry Purcell's Dido's Lament from his opera. Here's Adagio for Strings.
Thank you.
free concert harp masterclass. I'd like to invite Cynthia Krause forward for an encore performance. She will be performing Etude number 3 from violin Partita number 1 by Johann Sebastian Bach. Please welcome her. She's getting set up, all right? Try the harp out, and it was just so cool to see the expression on their faces when they were able to successfully play Twinkle Twinkle Little Star. It was just really it was a very, very wonderful thing yesterday that Cynthia did, and just sharing her incredible artistry on the instrument. Thank you so much, Cynthia. Another hand. kind of, in between the next few selections, I'm going to highlight a number of strengths, key strengths in our orchestra. And there's kind of three different groups. The first is just the wide range of disciplines that are part of this orchestra. You can see in your program all those, all the different majors represented. Excellence here translates to excellence elsewhere, and the same is true of the work that they're doing outside of this orchestra, what they bring to this group. It's an eclectic mix, and I love it. And you can probably see this on your program. The next time you get a chance to see us perform is on Tuesday, April 23rd. We're going to merge, collaborate with the concert band and do some full orchestra selections, so please save the date for that. This next selection, I'm going to pull the program note right from the catalog advertisement for it. It says, this next selection has it all. A slow introduction, evocative of an ancient chant, breaks through to a sprightly jig that features solo violin. Once the orchestra is joined into the rollicking tune, the solo fiddle takes it up another notch by introducing an even faster reel. The excitement builds as each section joins in and accelerates to the rousing finish. Please join me in welcoming our soloist, Annika Dobrev.
Thank you.
next key strength in this orchestra are the community members. Learning a string instrument takes a lot of work, often years of study. So unless the student started back in high school or middle school or earlier, it would be difficult, maybe impossible, to play in this orchestra. So these community members support our students and set the example of a lifetime study and joy of music. Join me in thanking them. This next selection by Shostakovich is a favorite of one of our community members, Megan Werwine. Here's waltz number 2. back in 2017, the music department embarked on an all Steinway campaign, and just this last semester we announced we have completed this campaign. So we are an all Steinway school, which means that every piano on this campus is either a Steinway piano or a Steinway designed Boston piano. All the practice rooms, classrooms, rehearsal spaces, performance spaces have these magnificent pianos. And this one right here, this Steinway D, is the best piano in Mankato. So it's just so wonderful to have these wonderful instruments here. To introduce the next selection, here's also the website promo for it. Add some sizzle to your next concert with some Bollywood style. Maharaja combines rhythms and motifs from Indian music with exciting melodies. Slurred pizzicato imitates the sound of tabla drums, while finger snaps and triplet flourishes add to the South Asian flavor. Here's Maharaja. So our final key strength to a successful ensemble are our music majors. We need leaders in music. Our goal at Bethany is this: to give students the knowledge and skills they will need to be successful stewards of their craft of music, encouraging them to be competent, enthusiastic, and creative, capable of using music in a variety of ways to glorify God while enriching people's lives. Music majors set the example of excellence and character for others to follow. Their leadership here will translate to leadership throughout life. Please join me in recognizing the music majors. There's two that just graduated in December. So would you?
stand. Tomorrow, Madeline. And then 5 current music majors, please stand. Let's give them a big hand.
Last summer, I had the opportunity to travel to England with 14 BLC students, and we visited Oxford. I read about a lecture done by C.S. Lewis there at the start of World War II. It was titled, "Does Beauty Matter When Bombs Start Falling?" Lewis offers 3 key points. If we waited for peace to create art, the first cave painting would still not be made. There will always be some imminent danger looking more important than culture, yet culture breaks through. Second thing, insect life versus human life. The insects have chosen a different line. They have sought first the material welfare and security of the hive, and presumably they have their reward. Men are different. We demand not just mere continuity, but variety, growth, and adventure. And the last point, finally, the soul feeds on truth and beauty like the body feeds on food. God makes no appetite in vain. We can therefore pursue knowledge and beauty in the sure confidence that by so doing, we are either advancing to the vision of God ourselves or indirectly helping others to do so. So does beauty matter when bombs start falling? Think about cave paintings, insects, and the soul. Hopefully that helps you towards that answer. We're going to hear now a selection by one of the greatest composers ever, Johann Sebastian Bach and Batanari. So my sons, for whatever reason, are great at solving Rubik's Cubes. I am not. And I think Bach's music is like somebody that knows how they're solving a Rubik's Cube. And they're going like this, and all, and they know what they're doing. I have no clue. And then you get to the very end, it's like, oh, that's Bach's music. I think it's just extraordinary. So a few quick announcements here. Our college concert band is performing in 2 days. So their home concert is here, and then they go on a tour from March 6th to the 10th. So this Tuesday night at 7:30, please come back and hear the College Concert Band. And also over spring break, and that's the first part, March 1st to the 4th, I'm taking 9 music majors on the road, and we're performing throughout Minnesota and Iowa. If you're available on Monday, March 4th, we'll be at Risen Savior School at 11 a.m. and Mount Olive Lutheran School at 1:45 that afternoon. So we've got a number of, we get to move outside of Mankato and have other churches and schools get a chance to hear us. It's going to be wonderful. We will, in a moment here, be ending on a really good note. I have to share that, unfortunately, I woke up this morning and my eye is very irritated. I don't know if you can tell from here. It's my eye. It's not me. It's my eye. It might be pink eye, which is terrible to announce, but it means, it's awkward, but I'm going to just head out right after this last election. It's not to be rude. I love seeing you all here. It's so wonderful. Thank you so much for coming. I'm going to duck out. You shouldn't be in close contact with people, so yes. So please do, if you so choose, send me a text or send me an email. Let me know how the concert went, but more than that, do let them know. Just outstanding work this semester, and this group is fantastic. I don't know, I'm sort of speechless, because it's so wonderful to work with you guys, and the concert that you've done here is just beautiful. So thank you, and thank you, Jupiter. So you can see, I would say, like, look at the artist's work there. That's amazing, those three works that they did and the descriptions with it. And this is Gustav Holst, Jupiter. Thank you all so much. Have a wonderful rest of your day.